seeing the young talent they had already,
right,
and then seeing the veteran players that came over, right, Jimmy to Taj to Teague to just those guys, and seeing what they're building. Mm-hmm. You know, I didn't want to be just another, I don't know, if it was like my last year,
right,
it would make more sense to me to go, okay, you know, another team that's already ready-made. But right, I wanted to kind of embrace the journey and go through it with these guys.
Could you see, like, the did the role seem clear to you before you even got here? I mean, we know what you can do as a sixth man, but did you see yourself kind of comfortably settling in? Could you see that opening?
Yeah, I just saw the guys that were here, high-character guys, you know, and at this point in my career, you kind of know what you're getting.
Right.
And Tibbs is very clear. My teammates are very embracing. The city was great. So I thought, for me, it was pretty clear cut.
Okay.
What can you do as a veteran to sort of help these younger guys? Obviously, been around, seen the league. What kind of advice can you give to them?
Just to be consistent. I think that kind of separates teams. And that doesn't mean you won't have tough shooting nights, but just consistent in your approach and everything you do. You know, and from the off-the-court work to the on-the-court, just being a true professional. And not saying they weren't before. You know, I've learned that. That's very important over my years.
Thank you. You know, everybody wants this stuff to happen overnight. Obviously, it doesn't.
Yeah.
But how do you balance knowing that it's going to take some time, but still not using it as an excuse and having some sense of urgency?
Yeah, you take it day by day, but you still think big picture as well. You know, and for us, being competitors, you want to win every single time on the court, even when we're in practice against each other.
Right.
You want to win that drill, that scrimmage, you know, but it's not realistic to go 82-0. And for us, sometimes we're going through things for the first time or experiencing things for the first time in front of 20,000 people in the world. You know, it's not like practice, like, oh, we can correct that. And sometimes that's that, but other times you get an overhaul like we've had. You know, it's going to be some learning curves and things of that nature.
The defensive numbers sort of are what they are right now, but have you seen encouraging signs? Or have you
seen absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. If you look at it, I think I don't even know the numbers, but just off the top of my head, I know we've been in like four really close games.
Right.
And we won three of the four.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and for me, I don't think that's just offense. I think that's defense as well.
Right.
So, I don't know. The numbers are what they are, and it's a small sample size.
Right.
But I'm sure we'll be a lot better in December than we are now.
Right.
You know, I think we'll continue to improve as the season goes along.
Is there any sort of one or two keys that you think would be in terms of getting this group to reach its potential? Is there any specific area that you guys have to focus on?
Just being all the way. I mean, for us, I think just being all the way bought in. And I have no question that every person that puts on a uniform is all the way bought in. And Tibbs has the plan. There's nobody that's going to prepare us more. So we just got to go out there and carry it. As it goes on, we'll get better and better at it.
Thank you.
No problem.
From your experience, is there a benchmark of judging teams, 10 games, 20 games, 40 games?
Nah, it's just a weird thing. If you look at, we're in Miami, so if you look at that team, if you go back to the year they won it, I think 06, they were kind of 500 or right above most of the season. And I think the last 20 games they got hot and found their groove and found their rhythm, and they kind of carried that throughout the playoffs. So, you know, you just never know. Every group is different. I've been on teams where we started, you know, out the gate 14-2, or, you know, and then still lost in the first round of the playoffs. So you just never really know.
Our Miami last year, 11-30.
Yeah, look how hot they got last year. You just never know. So, you know how it is in the league. And if you go a week with winning, it's like things are the best things in the world. And then you go a week where you struggle a little bit, it's like all the sky is falling. So you just got to stay even keel and never let your highs get too high or lows too low.
In terms of individual talent, how do you compare this team to the other one that you played before?
It's too early to judge, to give you an honest answer. I just think, you know, we have to go through things first and see how we respond to it. And then after being here for a period of time, I can give you a more honest answer. But right now, I would be making something up. And I don't want to do that. So I want to be as honest as possible.
That's what we do.
Whatever. You said it, I did.
You need to say something about Seattle.
It's the best place in the world.
I know you do, you're pretty active.
Yeah. No, it's a special place to me. It's a place that I feel like made me and who I am. And not just on the court, off the court. Like, the people there are wonderful people. And everybody looks out for everybody. And that's why I think our basketball culture is different.
You think you will come back to the NBA?
Yeah, I hope so. I hope so. I really do. If you look at our fans with the Seahawks, you look at our fans with the Sounders, you look at our fans with our baseball team, and they're really good. We have great fans, a great fan base, so hopefully we get a team back there soon.
It is also tradition, right?
Yeah, it's tradition. They won a championship in 79, so it's tradition for sure.
Thank you.
No problem.